This is a model of the silicon unit cell. Each ball represents a silicon atom. The orientation of this atomic structure affects the electrical, chemical, and physical properties of the silicon surface used to make integrated circuits. If a silicon ingot is grown with its axis parallel to the x-axis, each wafer sliced from the ingot has its surface aligned with this plane, the 100 plane. The three numbers are the Miller indices. The plane intersects the x-axis at x equal 1 and does not intersect the y-axis or z-axis. Let's look in the 100 direction, meaning perpendicular to the 100 plane. With the cube turned 45 degrees, the atoms line up in neat rows and columns. Wafers are made with a notch or a flat portion aligned with the rows. If you strike a 100 wafer with a sharp object, it fractures along the atomic rows and columns, forming pieces with edges at 90 degrees. For an ingot grown with its axis aligned with the long diagonal through the cube, each wafer sliced from the ingot has its flat surface parallel to this plane, which intersects the axes at x equal 1, y equal 1, and z equal 1. This is the 1-1-1 orientation. Let's look in the 1-1-1 direction by lining up two diagonally opposite corners. Now the atoms are arranged in a hexagonal pattern. If you strike a 1-1-1 wafer with a sharp object, it fractures into pieces with edges at 60 degrees. The 100 wafer orientation is the most common for CMOS integrated circuits. The 1-1-1 orientation is sometimes used instead. Another orientation, 1-1-0, is less common. To view a unit cell in that direction, line up one edge behind the opposite edge, like this. Now let's look at how the atoms are arranged inside the unit cell. Silicon, like carbon, has four electrons in its outer shell and readily forms four covalent bonds with other atoms. The lines joining the centers of four adjacent atoms form a tetrahedron, consisting of four equilateral triangles. A tetrahedron fits perfectly inside a cube. The vertices of the tetrahedron coincide with four of the cube vertices. The edges of the tetrahedron form diagonal lines across all six faces of the cube. In the silicon or diamond cubic crystal structure, the cubes are arranged in a 3D checkerboard pattern, filled, filled, empty, empty, filled, filled, empty, empty. In a 2D checkerboard, the smallest unit that can be repeated in a rectangular fashion is a 2x2 array containing two colored squares and two plain squares. For the same reason, in a 3D checkerboard, the smallest unit that can be repeated is this 2x2x2 array containing four filled cubes and four empty spaces. Here's a model of the connected tetrahedrons of a unit cell. This larger shape is also a tetrahedron, which fits perfectly into the unit cell cube. Each small tetrahedron represents a central atom and its four neighboring atoms. So the unit cell has four atoms in the centers of the small tetrahedrons, an atom in each of four corners, 1, 2, 3, 4, and an atom in the center of each face of the unit cell, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here's the model showing individual atoms. Here's a central atom, a connection to the nearest corner of the unit cell, and connections to the centers of the three faces that meet at that corner. The same is true for each of the small four tetrahedrons. Some corners have an atom without any connections, for example, here. This atom's connections are in four adjacent unit cells that meet at the same corner. This one, this one, this one, and this one. In case you still have trouble visualizing the atomic positions, here's an alternative model using just two cubes. On the unit cell, place 1/8 of an atom at each corner, and half an atom at the center of each face. Take a half-size cube and place whole atoms at four diagonally opposite corners, with nothing inside. Suspend the smaller cube in the middle of the bigger one. Just add sticks between adjacent atoms, and you get exactly the same model. Here, 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 and so on. I hope you now understand the structure of the silicon unit cell. For more details and some useful links, read the video description.